significant functions that we have things that we just have to memorize. That's kind of going to be true, I think, about some of the natural or the logarithm stuff. Some things you just kind of have to memorize them. And actually, you guys have done really well with the trig functions. Y'all seem to know them.
Y'all seem to know their derivatives real well.
It's just when they go chain rule, I know that messes us up a little bit. All right, so the rule for natural exponential functions, so that's anything that's got an e.
E to the anything. It would be considered a natural exponential function. So if we're going to take the derivative of that, so I'm going to use the d over dx notation. We don't use it very often. We haven't used it enough, so I'm going to use it so that we kind of get used to seeing it. I'm going to say e to the f of x because if it was just e to the x, technically that's a function up there, right? E to the x. X is a function, so it could be any function up there. If we come across this, chain rule is pretty much enforced. F of x being up in the treehouse is considered being inside of something.
It's like inside the treehouse.
So we have to take the derivative of the inside piece. So I would take the derivative of f of x. And then you have to multiply that times the derivative of the whole thing, which, remember, the derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. So this is just going to be e to the x.
So this one's pretty easy because it pretty much is just a chain rule. So if we look at this first one, I got to take the derivative of my inside piece, and I have a piece inside the treehouse, and what's the derivative of sine x? All right, so the first part's going to be cosine x. And then I multiply that by the derivative of the whole thing, which would be e to the sine x.
Can you leave it like that?
Yeah, that's it.
So the next one's just...
So I'm going to take the derivative of the inside piece. So what's the derivative of the inside piece? So it's going to be 2 times e to the 2x plus c.
No, it's 2 sine x.
Not bad, right?
Okay.
So next one. Derivative of the inside piece. 2 times the derivative of the whole piece. That one I will simplify, make it 6e to the 2x. Are we good so far?
Yeah.
Okay, so not bad. Now, the next one is product rule. Okay, so would it make it easier if we wrote out notation first? Okay, so if I'm going to say, I'm going to call this h of x. My first piece is h of x, and then my second piece I'm going to call g of x, so that I can write out what I need to do, because it's a product rule. So I'm going to look for h prime of x times g of x plus g prime of x times h of x. All right, so the derivative of the h piece, what's the derivative of the h piece?
2
times just the g of x part, so it's just going to be e to the 3x plus the derivative of the g piece. Now, be careful because you got a chain rule situation here when we take this derivative. Because 3x, what's the derivative of 3x?
3.
Right? And then e to the 3x. So that's the derivative of g of x. And then I multiply that by h of x, which is just 2x plus 3. Now, there's nothing wrong with this as your solution, but I have these e to the 3x's. Those are like bases. So there's a real good possibility if I distribute this, I can simplify. So if this was a multiple choice test, they're going to simplify it. So I'm going to distribute this. So my first piece stays the same, 2e to the 3x. Plus, this is now going to be 6xe to the 3x plus 9e to the 3x.
two pieces that are alike and get 11 e to the 3x plus 6 x e to the 3x. Is everybody sort of okay? The next one is product rule also. So try it. Take a second and try it and see how you do. So I'm writing it out, find the derivative of the first piece, so that's going to be
2x.
All right, so when I go to find the derivative of my second piece, I have to use chain rule, because that 2x up there is a function, so 2 e to the 2x times h of x. I actually think that's it. I can't really simplify it. That's it? You could rewrite. You probably would rewrite this and put the x squared in front. So it would be 2x e to the 2x plus 2x squared e to the 2x. That's probably how they would write it. You put the x, since this x was after the 2, then you put that one after the 2 also. But you just have to remember to look for your answer. And make sure that you kind of manipulate your answer to look like what they're looking for. Because it's the most interesting question. All right, I'm going to rewrite this first. F of x equals e to the 2x minus 6. All right, this is like chain. Well, two chain. We got two chains. So I've got two first. Take the derivative of 2x minus 6. So that's 2 times e to the 2x minus 6. So that's the derivative of the inside piece times the derivative of the outside piece. Multiplication. So I have a 2 here and a 2 here that can cancel. And then this is going underneath in a square root, so it's going to be e to the 2x minus 6 over square root of e to the 2x minus 6.
Is everybody okay?
Three. I technically could, I guess, can factor out the e part too. But I know the only thing that's going to cancel is the 3x on bottom. So I could factor out a 3x, and that would leave me x times 5e to the 5x minus 2e to the 5x all over 3x squared times 3x squared. So my 3 can cancel with my 3 on bottom, and this x can cancel with one of these x's, which leaves me x times 5e to the 5x minus 2e to the 5x over 3x cubed.
So what's that 3x on that second part?
Right here?
On that bottom, what's that?
So it was 3x squared, because remember it's low, yeah. So it was 3x squared, but I had 1x up here, so I could cancel one of the x's. So it's not squared anymore.
So
I canceled the 3's and one of the x's. So now it's x times 3x squared, right, which is where I got 3x cubed. Now, this is a perfectly acceptable answer because you have, and this happened on a problem before, because you have the same e value, they might factor out that e. If you were looking for your answer, and all you would have to look at is go, oh, it's, I distributed it, they didn't. So it would be e to the 5x, and then it would be 5x minus 2 over 3x cubed. Because they just took the e to the 5x out because they both had one. It can be written either way. It doesn't really matter. You just have to be able to look for it. All right, are y'all okay? You seem okay. You seem like we're good. Pretty good? Okay. All right, this next part is like the part of, that I was talking about earlier where you kind of just have to memorize how you do it. So, the derivative of, now we're looking for the reverse, which is natural log. Alright, if we have a natural logarithm, then in order to find the derivative, do y'all remember what the derivative of just natural log x is? 1 over x. So if there's a function inside of it, it's going to be the derivative of the function over the original. All right.
Okay.
So in this case, it, I mean, actually.
So it's just 2 over.
Yeah.
2 over 2.
Yep. So the derivative of this one is the derivative of the inside.
Which is 2x.
So 2. Over 2x minus 3. So remember, whatever's inside of the argument of the logarithm, that's your f of x. So if I'm finding the derivative of this, I just got to take the derivative of that inside piece there. So it's going to be 6x plus 2. Over the original f of x. No, it's not, you just have to remember that that's what you're supposed to do. Alright, so what about this one?
Negative
sine x over cosine x. Now, what is sine x over cosine x? Tangent. So this one would be negative tan x.
Yeah, I remember back in algebra in like 7th grade, I saw these buttons on the calculator, I thought they were just random.
You were in algebra in 7th grade?
Yeah. I missed my class.
I took it 8th grade.
Or 8th grade, that's what I'm doing, my bad.
I wish you took algebra 7th grade. It's gross.
Alright, so I have to take the derivative of the function, so it's going to be 1 half.
Is this a chain rule?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, what?
Alright, so the 2 and the 2, those cancel. Alright, so I end up with, so the 2 and the 2 cancel, I end up with
1 times 2x minus 4 to the negative 1 half. Well, that negative 1 half moves it down here with the other 2x minus 4 to the 1 half. So if I have 2x minus 4 to the 1 half times 2x minus 4 to the 1 half, when you multiply radical by itself, it just cancels the radical. Or you can think of it when you multiply like bases, you add their exponents, 1 half and 1 half is 1. So it'd be 2x minus 4 to the 1.
Let's say 2x minus the square.
Bar, so second divide gives you the e to the x power sine x. And then, I should close that parentheses. And then over here where it says x equals, they want my x to equal negative 2.
And they just put it
in. And that's the answer.
Or decrease.
Negative 0.538, which means f of x is decreasing because f prime of x is less than 0. Same thing. So I can just arrow up and grab it. You'll know that, right? You can arrow up and highlight it, hit enter. And now I'm just changing the x value from negative 2 to positive 1.
That's a big difference in the number.
And enter. 11.268. And x is increasing. I guess I should put the number in. F prime of is greater than. Alright, I'm going to get a new thing so we keep a page and time to all that stuff. Alright, so this time.
Did you just press my phone?
Yeah. So I'm going to do alpha y equals 1 and get a fraction bar.
Okay.
Natural log.
What are fraction
bars? It's right next to 4, kind of.
Yeah, mine's slightly out.
It's probably worn out.
Yeah.
Alright, cosine x over x squared, pi over 3, so -3/7/2, f of pi over 3 is d. needs, it's undefined. Which means...
horizontal?
No, a horizontal tangent would be zero.
Oh.
So it's a vertical tangent. Increasing. Okay, so real quick on this one. All right, so this is one of those where you can't put in your calculator the way it's written on the page. Because of the way we write these in notation, you're going to have to put in this. 5 parentheses sine log x squared. So even though this pops up as a parentheses, my 5 is going to go in, and then I have to put another set of parentheses for the sine natural log x. Close that parentheses, close my second parentheses, square that.
Negative 0.00002456.
So you did parentheses squared, right?
Yeah, because you can't put a 2, and your calculator won't let you put a 2 right after the word sign. So you have to put the whole sign in parentheses and square it.
See, it's not letting me put another. Like, it's not letting me arrow over to the outside parentheses to put
yeah.
a square.
Oh, that outside one. I just did the square before that one.
You square before it. It's on the parentheses you put on there, not their outside one. Because we're squaring it before the 5.
So the sine parentheses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's parentheses sine log x parentheses squared, close parentheses. So see, on this, you should have a parenthesis because the way we put it in, it should be another set outside of that.
Yes. Honestly, it doesn't matter where your parenthesis is.
So you typed it in
5.
You just said 5.
Parenthesis. Sign. And when I hit sign, a parenthesis automatically came up.
Yes.
So then I typed log x. I had to close that parenthesis that they gave me. Then I had to close the one I put in and square it.
Okay.
And then theirs should be on the outside. So it's decreasing.
And then I still got a completely different answer.
You did? check and see. Check your...